I'm a mother, teacher, guide and a friend, and these are my life lessons. I'm Dr. Neeti Kaushik and welcome to my channel, Nitty Gritty with Dr. Neeti Kaushik.
Hi, are you one of those who is not even shy of saying anything which comes to your mind? Or you are one of those, you know, who takes so much of a time to speak what is there inside you? Are you that person who always feels that यार दिल तो कर रहा है इसको सब कुछ कह दूं बट देन यू नो यू रिस्ट्रिक्ट योरसेल्फ यू रिस्ट्रेन योरसेल्फ यू डोंट हैव दैट पावर यू डोंट हैव दैट स्ट्रेंथ यू डोंट हैव दैट इनर स्ट्रेंथ और यू नो यू फील दैट द समथिंग चोकिंग इनसाइड एंड द सो मच इनसाइड दैट यू वांट टू वॉमिट आउट स्पीक आउट बट यू नो बिकॉज ऑफ नॉर्म्स बिकॉज ऑफ रिलेशंस बिकॉज ऑफ टेक यू नो बिकॉज ऑफ रिस्पेक्ट और बिकॉज यू टेक केयर ऑफ अदर पीपल यू रिस्ट्रिक्ट योरसेल्फ from speaking what you need to speak. If that is so, there's every possibility that your throat chakra is perhaps blocked. So welcome to Nitty Gritty with Dr. Neeti Kaushik, and today's video is going to be about throat chakra. You would have understood it, right? So we have already discussed four chakras. This is the fifth chakra. It is also known as Vishuddhi chakra. Now when I say Vishuddh, Vishuddh means Shuddh, Vishuddh. Right, so when we say Shuddh, Shuddh means what? Pure nectar, something which is going to be giving you purity, right? So it comes from here. Shivji ne bhi apne gale mein kya kiya tha? Story yaad hai na? Or should I repeat it? Right, so the same manner, this is the throat chakra which takes care of so many things. And the element is sound. Obviously we're talking, sound is being produced, so the element is sound. And very importantly, the color is sky blue. I'm wearing the color. Now let's first and foremost, let's understand as to, you know, what all comes under the throat chakra. One part we have understood. Let us understand the other things that come under the throat chakra. So first and the foremost thing that comes under the throat chakra is your expression. Now, is your expression clear or and honest, or is your expression faulty? In terms of speaking, are you keeping things to yourself or is your expression honest? If it is honest, if it is clear, that means your throat chakra is balanced. Second important thing is communication. Are you speaking to anybody with complete honesty? And are you there to hear others speak also? Or you are the only one who is going to speak all the time? That also comes under throat chakra. The third important thing is purpose. Am I aware that what is the knowledge or the message or the skills that I am sharing? What are the talents for which I have come here for? What is my life purpose? What is it that I need to share with others? Or I am simply beating about the bush and I am all talking all nonsense here and there, just trying to win the brownie points for the person who is in front of me? Next important aspect that it covers is integrity. Do I act and speak with sincere morality? Next part is creativity. Do I have outlet to express, or am I inspired and do I act on my inspiration? The next is acceptance. Do I accept myself and my feelings, or half the time I'm trying to restrain my feelings into my own self and I feel like a lot of heaviness onto my chest? This is also what is reflected in the throat chakra. Then the next part is honesty. How honest I am in my day-to-day dealings. Do I speak lies from morning to evening? Am I every now and then blocking my throat chakra because I am speaking in entire dishonesty? Or I am trying to save my skin by being dishonest? Or am I honest enough to understand and say that, okay, this is my fault. I have taken up this decision, or I have spoken like this and somewhere I need to mend myself. So am I honest towards both the things or not? Last but not the least is authenticity. Am I genuine? Do I respect others in genuinity? Or it's only a superficial life that I'm leading? And most of the time, what I realize now is most of the people are leading a superficial life. What we are posting on the social media is entirely different than what actually happens in our lives, in day-to-day lives, when we deal with human resources. Okay, so first and foremost, we'll be talking about how do we figure it out that we have imbalances in our throat chakra. Now there are two aspects which we have to always monitor. One is the physical problems, that means in our body the kind of problems that happen because of the closed throat chakra or imbalanced throat chakra or not a clarity in throat chakra. The second would be the personality issues. So first and foremost, let me take up quickly the physical problems. The physical problems, I'm going to list them down. You can take a screenshot or else you can pen them down and understand whenever anything like this is happening. So there is something which a remedy or some requirement in terms of healing the throat chakra is there. So first and foremost, thyroid. All those people who are suffering from thyroid must ensure that they must understand that there is a problem with the throat chakra. Second important thing, sore throat. As and when, it's not there forever. So as and when it so happens, like it is there for me nowadays. So as and when it so happens, you have to understand that you have to heal it. Then the next third part is mouth ulcers. Next is neck ache. Whenever we have neck ache in bending the neck, we are unable to bend the neck left or right or center or forward or backward. Then the next is tongue issues. Whenever we have blisters on the tongue. Of course, we always relate it with food also, but this is one of the primarily important reasons for this. Then another important aspect is the dental issues. So whenever there will be issues in our teeth, so there is an understanding as to there is a problem required. Now I'll be talking about the personality issues. So there are almost 13 to 14 points which we need to understand in terms of personality issues. Poor listener, first and foremost. Lack of purpose in life. We don't even know what we are here for. What are we doing? Why are we here? And we just simply kill our days by browsing through the channels or by chit-chatting or bitching or speaking all nonsense or, you know, getting hurt ourselves and keep crying and sulking over the things which have happened. Next is excessive fear of speaking. Then next is small and unclear voice. When your voice is very, very unclear, you speak very meekly and, after such a long time, after the other person has spoken about five sentences, then you might speak about a sentence. So that is another thing. You are shy of making large friend circle. You don't feel comfortable with a huge friend circle. And, you think twice before you speak anything to anybody. You are very indecisive. Every time you depend on others to take decisions on behalf of you. Half the time you are dishonest in terms of you dealing with your own self or dealing with others or dealing with any work which is given to you. You are dishonest in that. You are unable to focus on a task and you keep flickering. You have a flickering mind that 10 minutes I am on this task, another 10 minutes I am on other task, then 10 minutes on another task. Then you are unable to hold your attention to anything. If you sit down for meditation, your mind will be all over the place. If you sit down to write something, your mind will be doing something else and you'll stop that work and you'll start doing something else. Another is that you will be often mumbling. You're just sitting idle and you're speaking to yourself and mumbling about other people, mumbling because you're not able to speak in front of the people. So what are you doing? You're just sitting and mumbling all to yourself. So these were a couple of aspects which are the traits which are there, which are not the positive traits and they hurt and harm the throat chakra in terms of your personality. So we have spoken about the physical traits. We have also spoken about the personality traits. Now, how are we going to unblock them? Okay, before I do this, I'll also quickly tell you that what are the signs if your throat chakra is not blocked and it is perfect in order. So those signs are, again, I'm giving you the list so you can take the screenshot or else you can write them down. We will be calm, peaceful, decisive, authentic, honest, patient, high level of creative expression, high level of integrity, true to oneself, centered, and speaking with clarity and confidence, whatever is coming to our minds, right? So if a person is very clear with all these things, that means the throat chakra is absolutely perfectly functioning in a perfect order. Now let me move to the next part. The next part is going to be, how are we going to unblock the chakra, which is the throat chakra? So first and foremost, I'm talking about the crystals. So again, quickly, please take a screenshot and write down the names. You can pick and choose any one crystal out of them. You can have a bracelet, the way I wear some of the bracelets, and I keep changing and wearing the bracelets as per what attracts me the most, not as per what chakra is blocked, but generally, yes, as per what attracts me the most. Similarly, also you to an extent what chakra is blocked. You can also wear any part of jewelry, or while you are sitting in the meditation, you don't want to wear any jewelry or bracelets if in case there are men or boys here. So what you can do is you can simply hold that particular crystal in your hand while you are sitting for your prayers. You can just hold it in your hands, and while you are chanting or you are meditating, you can keep it with you so that it passes on the energies to you. Now the names of the crystals quickly. Blue lace, agate, solatite. Then you have aquamarine, turquoise, calcite, kainite, blue topaz, mezzanite, lapis lazuli. I think I pronounce it this way because I think I'm pronouncing it right, because I really do not know how to pronounce the word. Now moving to the next, which is the food which helps you. Of course, blue food, but then there are certain other foods also which really help you to clear your throat chakra, is one, blue grapes. We have green grapes, we have blue grapes, so the purplish bluish grapes which are there. Blueberries, excellent. Barley, excellent source. Dragon fruit. Then we have apples. Then coconut water is superb. Mushrooms, wheatgrass, plums and seaweeds. Even lemon helps to cure your throat chakra, right? Whenever we have a sore throat, don't we say have lemon water? Shahad aur neembu ke saath aap pani piyenge to you'll be relieved with the throat. So that is another option. Now I move to the essential oils. How are you going to use the essential oils? You are either going to put it here on your palm, or else behind your neck, or else put a few drops of the essential oil into the water that you take bath with. So you can have multiple essential oils and you can pick and choose whenever you need any. Otherwise also it gives you, you know, a very amazing feeling. So the list of essential oils, this is it. Jasmine, geranium, eucalyptus, lavender, sage and cypress. These were the essential oils. Now I move to herbs. Which kind of herbs are there which you should use a little regularly, at least one of them every day? So cinnamon, cloves, peppermint, lobelia. So these are the herbs that you can use. Now I move to sounds. Sound, what is the Beej Mantra for throat chakra? The Beej Mantra is hum. Right? So when we are going to be reciting the Beej Mantra, how are we going to do it? We will be closing our eyes and we will be sitting in the lotus position and we will be chanting the Beej Mantra hum. So hum. Oof, what a feeling it gives. So the Beej Mantra is hum, and the frequency for any of the other chants, in order to, if you are wanting only to listen and not to chant, just want to listen with the frequencies, then the frequency is 384 hertz frequency. Google it on the YouTube and you are going to be finding lot of frequencies which are available. Those music pieces you can just plan to put them and just listen to them for about 10-15 minutes. It's going to do wonders and magic to you. Then I move to another aspect, is singing of the birds. If you have birds around you, if you spend time in birds, especially in the morning and evenings when you are taking a walk or a stroll in a park and you have a lot of birds, like we have this tree outside our home where there are a lot of birds in the evening. They come and then they rest, and when they are coming and retiring back to their homes, so there's a lot of chirping which happens, and same happens in the morning also when they are up and awake, though it happens very early in the morning. But that is again another magical way to clear your throat chakra. Then also singing of crickets is an important aspect. Now coming to the yoga poses, there are a lot of yoga poses which can help you. Let me quickly again tell you all these yoga poses. Lion pose, cat pose, bridge pose, shoulder stand and hal asan. These are the yoga poses which can help you. Now mudras. The mudras are the dhyan mudra. When you have to sit, you have to cross your fingers on inside of the hand, right, and let the thumb touch at the top. Okay, this is how. So cross your fingers inside of the hand and touch your thumb. So this is how you are going to be sitting in the dhyan mudra, and that is the time while sitting in the dhyan mudra you will be chanting the Beej Mantra, which is hum. This is going to help you out. So this was all about understanding on the ways through which you can clear. Now I am going to be talking about the affirmations and the visualization. So affirmations, again I am listing them down. You can take a screenshot write them down, keep it, stick it somewhere where you feel before sleeping or in the morning you can read them, because before sleeping when you read something, that registers in your subconscious mind, and anything that goes in your subconscious mind is like an instruction that goes to your brain which has to be followed, and it is genuinely followed. You can try out this, and this really, really, really works. So all affirmations should be done at the bedtime before sleeping, or else first thing in the morning when you wake up. But that doesn't mean that at 10 o'clock you're going to be waking up. You have to be waking up pretty much earlier than that. That is around the sunrise or a little before the sunrise. So moving on to the affirmations, which affirmations are there which are going to help you? I speak with love. I honor my inner voice. I express myself with clarity. I express my gratitude towards life. I speak with kindness and love. I have words I need. My voice is strong and clear. When I speak, I do not back away from what is true. Clear? Now I'm going to be telling you what are the ways through which you can naturally heal yourself. So spend some time in the nature and spend some time where there are a lot of birds around you. Second important thing, most importantly, which I say, you know, these basically are the pent up emotions, feelings which do not come out of you, or you don't have the strength to bring them out. So what is the simplest way? Keep a journal. You can keep a diary, throat chakra. You can keep a diary, you can keep a journal. Pen down what is coming to your mind. Pen down what is coming to your heart. You know, just write down what is it that is troubling you inside. Because when you will be recording your feelings in the journal, what is going to happen is they will no more be inside you. They will be out where you have written. You may later on tear the page, you may throw the page, you may tear it and throw it in the bin. But at least they will come out, your feelings will come out. So it is always good to write a journal. Next is neck massage. Very important. So whenever possible, if you yourself can do it, you know, this is the way we do it. This is the way I think all the beauticians and all the beauty parlor ones, they know how to do. And we have so many videos which keep telling us to, you know, keep massaging your face and keep massaging your neck. So this neck exercise is going to help you. Next is practice being assertive, and at times you have to say no. Half the battle is won when you will be a little more assertive to say no. Respect and clear cut, make your boundaries. You know, we respect the relations, we respect everything, but at the same time, we are not able to say no. And inside, we hurt ourselves all the more. So the best way out is no. Then the next one is the call a friend and share your thoughts. Sometimes, you know, we are not able to speak to our immediate family. Sometimes we are not able to speak to people who are very, you know, who are in the hierarchy, maybe in the work or the office or wherever. But we can always talk to our friends who are the very, very close friends, because they would probably give us the another point of view, which we can sometimes think and ponder over it. We may or may not agree is a separate issue, but at least we can ponder over it. And another important aspect is meditation. If you have blue light in the area where you are meditating, that is going to help you immensely, because blue light, meditation in the blue light serves the purpose. You can light a blue candle, or else you can place a blue light around you. Walk in the open air. Again, it is sky and air. So when you are walking in the open air, when open to sky, that is going to relieve you, and that's going to help you in clearing your throat chakra. Of course, wearing blue clothes, as I am wearing today, and that's another suggestion, wearing blue clothes always help. Write letters. We've forgotten how we used to write letters earlier. I still remember in college, and way after that, even much after that, we used to write letters for page 6 to 7 or 10 pages. I still remember while I was in the hostel, so we used to, you know, wait for the letters to come. And we used to keep those letters nicely and safely with us, and we used to read and reread and reread and reread. Now it's just a time of gadget where we read something and we delete it with a tick of the button. We don't even remember what's there written, right? So writing is something really immensely good. That's why we talk about journaling. That's why we talk about writing. So write letters, sing songs, because the more happy you are internally, that happiness will come out in the open. आप अपनी भावनाओं को व्यक्त कर सकते हैं अगर आप गाना गा के किसी को कुछ कहना चाहते हैं तो. इट्स नॉट, सॉन्ग इज नॉट ऑलवेज टू बी संग, यू नो, टू इम्प्रेस अनदर पर्सन. दे कैन बी संग टू इवन योर pent-up feelings and emotions. So anyhow, it is on the lighter side. So this was all about the throat chakra. I hope you enjoyed this. Throat chakra ज़्यादातर thyroid की problems, throat chakra की problems ladies को ज़्यादा होती हैं, girls को ज़्यादा होती हैं, because most of the time they're not able to speak what is inside them, or they don't have the via media, or they don't have the friends, or they don't or they feel that they are cramped within themselves and they are unable to express themselves. So the in any form, creative form, in any form where you feel you can express, you can write a poem, you can write anything where your creativity is shown, I think that can make a whole lot of difference. So thank you so much. Thodi si lambi ho gayi ye video, but then I think it was important so that there are a lot of my knowns who always keep saying that you know, they are very shy of speaking. So this particular video is a tribute to all of you. Please try and use most of them and get over and evolve. So thank you so much. Now we are left with two more, and I'm sure we're going to have a wonderful time in completing this series on chakra balancing. And after that, I'll take small capsules as to we'll be doing meditations together, and also about numerology. So let me take the journey forward with this. I am sure that you are liking and enjoying even the videos that I'm creating on mental health, and the videos that I'm creating on understanding my own self emotionally and trying to evolve myself as a better person than what I was ever before. So these are a couple of things. I'll be very happy the way you are writing. Please keep penning them down, and also ask for what kind of suggestions or what kind of videos are you looking forward to, because then I can think on making the series on those particular areas and aspects. And once again, thank you for all your mails, all your letters, all your DMs, and I'm sorry I cannot read all of them all the time, but I try to because I spend about 1.5 to 2 hours in the evening you know, understanding all this and making my planner for the days ahead. And I think bahut bol liya. Thank you so much. God bless you. Stay happy, stay blessed, stay abundant, and love you all. Bada wala thank you dil se.